Thank you, Kathy. Yes.
So inflation for the poorest 30% income households now at levels we hadn't seen in 9 years. Are we looking at a steeper inflation trend for the poorest 30% going forward?
No, I think the average national inflation rate is 6.7%. So given that the poor's expenditures are concentrated on food commodities, rice, fish, sugar, vegetables, and meat, and those items have high inflation rates, naturally, the inflation rate for them would be higher. So it's about 1.3 percentage point higher than the national average.
So do you think that's going to taper off, or is that still going to go higher?
Well, we expect the inflation to, the average inflation rate from 6.7% to start tapering off toward the end of the year. And that should also follow regarding the specific inflation rate for the bottom 30%.
I spoke with Stan Charge Chido Narayanan on this show, and he said he'd rather see the government resolve the supply-side issues rather than suspend the second tranche of the fuel excise tax to fend off inflation. Do you agree?
Well, that's right. So the inflation rate in general for the whole country is it's a supply-side inflation rate determined. I mean, it's driven by supply side, not the demand side. So to some extent, in fact, to a large extent, he's right. And we agree. And that is why we have focused our attention on the four key food items, which is rice, fish, vegetables, and meat. Those are the four four items that have high inflation rates. If you break down the inflation rate.
The Finance Undersecretary Carl Chua said in the Senate hearing yesterday the suspension or planned suspension of the fuel excise tax could mean budget cuts for Pantawid Pasada and Lakbay Aral. What do you make of the potential budget cuts to the conditional cash transfers?
Well, potential, when we cut something from the revenue side, we have to, sacrifice some items too in terms of spending that is, to be expected. And what we will follow is a hierarchy of essentiality. The essential expenditures like infrastructure, human capital, meaning investment in education and health, they will be their top priorities. Then we go down the hierarchy to the less essential items, and that's where we will focus. If we have to cut expenditures, it will be on the least essential items first, and then going up.
So are you in favor or not in favor of potential budget cuts to the CCTs?
Well, that's an agreement among the economic managers, the BBCC. So, of course, I agree. Well, I concur with that decision. That's the decision of the three economic managers, including myself.
Should the government suspend the second tranche for the excise tax or not?
Well, that will really depend on the movement of the global price of oil, because that is in the law. So we are closely monitoring the movement in the global price of oil. And depending on the movements, which way it goes, then we will make our decision when decision time comes.
But you would rather to keep it going if the Dubai crude didn't have to average $80 a barrel in 3 months.
Yes, that would be ideal if we can if we don't have to suspend the next fuel excise tax increase.
All right. Well, thank you so much for the update.